Hello, welcome back. This is Kenshin1913, and we are Let's Playing Suikoden 4. In the last episode, we finally made it to our own headquarters. That's right. We now have our own headquarters, sort of. It's not technically ours, it's the Kingdom of Obels. But this is where we'll be hanging out for a little while. So let's explore this area. So this is Louise. And we can change party members right now. I'm not going to. And yeah, we'll go to our rooms. And yeah, you're a kitty. Is the convening going well, I guess? Everything's going alright. And this guy, his name's Tov, and he's the one who designed this place. So yeah. This place is pretty awesome. One of my more favorite headquarters. Hey! Here's Chadley. And he'll open up a shop later. I'm not exactly sure which floor I'm supposed to be in right now, but... and what room is mine, but... alright, that's my room. So we don't want to go there yet, but we do want to check out over here. As you can see, this is the inn and the tavern. That's pretty cool. They have little signs there. This place is pretty big. War room. What's up here? Can't go there. Let's check out the war room. Where there's war. In the entire room. Hey, look, they got nice chairs. We can sit down, maybe play chess or something. That could be a lot of fun. What else do we have here? The bar. This is the saloon on the first floor. Let's head down. You're not gonna let me go down? Apparently we can't go down. Alright. So let's go rest in our room. On the first floor. Or second. Whatever. It's over here. Let's take a nap. I'm not tired. Let's just... okay, there's a save point. Alright, let's rest up. I'm tired. It's been a long night. And look who it is. Leknot.
Please forgive my sudden appearance. I don't mean to frighten you. My name is Leknot. I am the guardian of the true runes. Some call me the executor of balance.
Yeah.
Embedded in your left hand is one of the true runes. That particular one is called the Rune of Punishment.
I know.
It is this rune that governs atonement and forgiveness. As the rune's power is used, its dreadful spell will consume its master's life, little by little.
Yes, I hear.
But, no matter how harsh the journey, you must remember that there are no trials that you cannot overcome.
Oh, nice. I have limitless potential.
Friends will help you along the way. Surround yourself with strength. The strength of many.
Will do.
Remember, I shall be monitoring the rune for a while, and more importantly, the way that you use it.
So at least Leknot's in this game, unlike Suikoden 3, she just basically appeared at the end. Alright, so Laszlo took a nap. Now we're ready to recruit some party members. Eventually we're going to go to the Ruins of Obel, but before we do, there's plenty of exploring to do and party members to get. So let's go. Alright, yeah, I'll take you guys out. So what we can do is talk with Louise and make some changes. Now what we can do is party formation. We're gonna add Chipu, Paula, and Jewel. And here we can actually do a support character. Just like in the other games, or at least in the third game, you had a support character and they can do various things for you. Like for Louise, she can do some healing, and they'll have the skills that they do in the corner there. But that's basically it. So we want to take Louise with us because she'll heal. And if we need to change our party member, I think we can just talk with her. Or something. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe not. I don't know. But there we go. So, those are our things. And how the hell do I get out of here now? Oh, here's Desmond. Oh, sweet. So, they gave us a ship. How the hell do I get out of here, Desmond? How do I leave? Can I leave through this door? Can I go downstairs? No, not yet. Maybe I go out through this door. No? Which way is the way out, Desmond? Oh, so we can talk to Desmond and change our party members. That's good to know. Alright, where's the exit? Oh, here we go. No. Where the hell is the exit? Because if we go through here, we apparently can't go through there. I think there's an exit out the way through Laszlo's room. Cliff path. There we go. Perfect. Perfect. Yeah, once again, be careful with these.
Now, in all honesty, I have just been assigned here, and I'm not entirely familiar with the situation at hand.
So now I guess we're heading
Nevertheless,
back to,
please begin.
The evil guys here. As you can see, there's Troy, there's Colton, there's Ramada, and some guy, and this guy, I guess, is the governor.
If I may, it is the light that was seen earlier that concerns us. It has not been seen around Rosaril since then.
Maybe this is like the Kuluk army?
In other words, this proves that this light has nothing to do with the land of Rosaril,
okay.
Correct?
So this guy here is Graham Cray. Apparently he has
But
a last
Sir
name.
Cray, I remember you saying...
Don't be hasty, Governor. I am saying that this light is something that shifts. Please humor me for now.
So, as you can see, Graham Cray's, like, look at his photo here, or avatar, or whatever the hell you want to call it. That is creepy. Look at those
I beg your pardon, Sir Cray, but your story, I cannot help but think it sounds like a work of fiction.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
This is coming from one who is known as the Child of the Sea God. Sorry for being so outlandish.
If you would please stop calling me that.
Troy, just let it go. There is no need to be so sensitive.
So apparently,
I know the achievements of each of your fleets, as does Sir Cray.
So apparently the governor
yes.
is a governor
Without
of the
you,
Kuluk?
We would be unable to fulfill the governor's plans for the southern expansion. In any case, I was told one of my men had a report for us. Ramada?
Yeah, this guy's a dick right here.
Pardon me, but I have brought with me a man who claims the possibility that the object in question has moved on from Rosaril.
Ah, bring him in.
As you wish. You may enter.
Who's this? Oh my god, Snow? He's gonna rat me out even more? Well, I think what ended up happening was the Kuluk guys ended up taking over Rosaril, as Colton was talking about earlier. And now he's basically Snow's either... it's explained a little later, but right now it looks like he's ratting us out. Telling us that we headed into a deserted ship, but who the hell knows where we went from there? Alright, there's something that they gotta be worried about. So now we can start recruiting and recording. I don't know what the hell we can be recording, but we can definitely be recruiting. Now if we come over here, we can talk to Emma and Gary. And they won't join our group right now. They apparently want to stay on Obel, which is fine with me. But yeah, we can't recruit. There's only one person we can recruit in Obel. So let's go talk to him. Where the hell is he? Not here. Must be down. I think he's on the main area. In the center. No. Not the doctor. Where is he? Maybe he's this way. Yeah, basically we're looking for Orin. Orin. This guy right here. You're looking for a certain woman. Well, I guess if you join with us, you can... Yeah. So yeah, we just got this party member, which is pretty cool. No, I don't want anything from you. Alright, so we grab what we need to grab. Let's go. That's all we can have. He's not too bad. The thing about him is, he starts off like... You remember Juan in the first game? He actually had a waking rune on him, so he's sleeping, and once he, the only way he can be awoken is with physical attacks. And then once he wakes up, he's berserked. And yeah, I'd like to use the ship. Now, the first place we're going to head to... Do they give us a sea chart? We're going to head, like, over here. Somewhere around here, there's a... There's actually an island called Mordor. So let's go. And yeah, I'm just holding down R1, and then I'm moving the left analog stick. And yeah, we're gonna be fighting around here with our group. Oh, I should check what these guys were. These lizards. Let's see. Oh, these lizards will poison you. Is that what they're doing? Poison lizards. There you go. Alright, I'll show off this rush thing. Well, no, in the next battle, I guess I will. Wow, these guys are pretty tough. Nice job, Laszlo. Alright, so new to this game, and new to the Suikoden series, they do, like, a sort of a combined attack. In the essence, let's use some antidotes. Do I have any? Oh, I don't need them when they're not in battle. Okay, that's cool. Good to know, I guess. Anyways, let's heal up Laszlo. Anyways, it's like, where is this island here? It should be around here somewhere. So yeah, really all I am is holding R1. Anyways, let's show off this rush attack. Get some new enemies. These are speckled rays. So what this rush attack is everyone combines their passive power in the Laszlo. He gets healed, and then he does this. Pretty cool ability, I think. Using up a turn without even having bad guys get to go, so I think that's pretty nice. And so how this, I think the way the rush ability builds up is after every battle you gain a little bit to that bar. Either that or it's damage. I'm not sure. I think it's damage. Oh no, so maybe it's battles. So maybe every so many battles it builds up. Oh wow, they do a pretty nasty attack there. Now, eventually we're... Oh, wow, you guys are really good on sitting there. Alright, let's not die. You know, Item on yourself. Item on yourself. Item on yourself. Yeah, so these guys are pretty tough. I'll stop showing these battles pretty soon. This big guy show this one. Leveling up. I need to go back and adjust my Oh, so as they level up, they actually like gain experience or HP. Alright, so this here's the island Mondo here. Or Mordo. Oh, we got some new enemies here. These guys are jellyfish men. Let's try off dancing flames. Let's do the shredding, what the hell. And then attack. I'm worried about these guys. I don't want. Probably because of that. Ooh, we get a stone of skill. That's always good. That'll permanently increase our skill. I'm always going to use them on Laszlo. Oh, it looks like what's-her-name's healing us. That's good, Louise. Anyways, let's head over to Mondo. Mordo. And here, this is a island apparently we can get attacked right away. And we fight some new enemies here. Paradise B. I guess I'll just attack them. Let's see how hard they are. Fairly tough. Yeah, this game, I'm gonna end up using more magic than anything. Especially since I don't really have my my guys really leveled up yet. I didn't get a chance to really, like, boost up their, weapons. So it's more likely we're gonna be using attack spells. There we go. Not too hard. So I think in this game, I'm gonna be like never meet an inn that I didn't like. So we come over here and we talk to this guy. Sure. Oh, damn it, you're only giving me that crap. So yeah, we can be attacked on the beach here. Uh-oh, we got some new enemies. Yellow Rodent and Rodent Leader. You know what? I'm going all out with the Blazing Wall. I don't really have anything on him. But yeah, you hear those creepy rodents? I don't like them. Let's try to put them to sleep. I don't need to heal anyone. Oh yeah, these balloon attacks. What these are about is if they put more than one balloon on you, I think it's up to three, you'll fly out of the battle, I guess. I've never had that happen to me ever. Well, actually, sometimes, right? And we got a wind rune piece. So, yeah, okay. Here we get a window set, and I want to say we gotta find a treasure map, and I can get the hell out of here. What's over here? Mordo Hot Springs, huh? How nice. Can we just take a dip? Oh, look at that. Okay, that's pretty cool. They have different, you can actually see them this time. It's, in Suikoden 3, you can see anybody. Does anyone run these hot springs, or I just come in here and do what I will? Anyways, let's grab that last chest, which should be, I'm assuming, this way, hopefully. I hope it's not all the way up the hill. These guys are pretty tough. apparently the hot springs did heal me up. Where the hell is this goddamn treasure? I need the treasure chest. Oh my god, look at all the rodents. Let's use another rune of blazing wall. Let's have everyone else defend. Money-wise, too. Alright, let's go up here. Oh, man, I gotta go up here? This is something we're gonna be exploring more later with a certain treasure hunter. Alright, I'm just gonna grab the treasure and get the hell out of here. But yeah, there's a certain... Where the hell's the treasure chest? Board it. Sail until you find board it and you have a reach. If you observe carefully on the map, there's a bit of brown color surrounding the region. Da 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 da. Let's see. There's an informant. Search the baskets behind the. Damn it! I didn't need to come up here. Search the baskets behind the hot springs. Son of a bitch. Oh, here's another new enemy. What the hell? Let's show it off. Killer fly. You know what? Let's use some more fire. Let's use some... breath of ice. Yeah, I would have to say Jewel is probably not the best spell cast. I could probably draw anyone else at this point. That Jewel, since I did end up getting some water runes. Right now, I'm getting all injured. Shit. Yay. So yeah. Nope. I wanna go back. Grab the goddamn treasure map, and then I'm gonna end the episode. In the next episode, we'll explore some more. Come on. That instant attack, instant kill attack those sons of bitches did. They killed Laszlo. Bastards. That's why you never travel alone. Never, ever, ever. Let's go back into the hot springs, heal up. Take a dip. Thank God for healing. Hot springs. Come on, let me out of here. Eventually there will be people here that you can actually get stuff from. Alright. These? No? Come on. Oh god. It's not these. It's gotta be back here. Come on. Oh shit, there's a guy here we can purchase stuff? Shit. Anyways, you want to buy bad silver ore. As you can see, like I said, anything under whatever. Let's see. Oh yeah, look. See, we can make some money. We bought that for less than under 50. So yeah. Alright, where the hell? Come on, really, game? Where the hell are the damn things? Harbor planks, one of them leads to hot springs where you can take a dip. There's an informant. Search the baskets behind the hot springs tent. How the hell do I get over there? Alright, I'm running from every goddamn thing till I find the goddamn... There we go. There's the goddamn treasure map. Anyways, I'm stopping here. In the next episode, we're gonna head to the island of Nay. And hell, if I got enough time, probably not, because Nay looks like it's a bigger area. So this has been Kenshin 1913. See you later. Bye-bye.